Well, as neurosurgeons, we not only do it with the brain, but we also deal with spine. One of the big questions that comes out always has been asked that what is the difference between a neurosurgeon doing a spine and an orthopedic surgeon doing the spine? And it's really at the end of it, it's just a matter of training. Neurosurgeons are trained to do spine from their second year of residency all the way through, and I'll tell my patients, for example, at fourth and fifth year of my residency, we were not doing that much spine anymore because we were done doing spine. We had done so many cases in spine that we not just switched to brain and the aneurysms and the tumors majority of the time. Whereas orthopedic surgeon has to do 5 years of joints, knee, hip, shoulder, and then 1 year fellowship in spine. So it is a slight difference in training. Having said that, there are certain things that is done in spine, for example, tumors of the spine. There are very, very few orthopedic surgeons that do tumors of the spine. The majority of that is done by neurosurgeons. As far as small cases, such as a simple disc herniation, microdiscectomies, and cervical fusions, two big cases, such as fusions of the lumbar spine, what they call a transthoracic approach to the thoracic spine, and complex spinal surgery, that's what us neurosurgeons do. Basically, it's from the simplest to most difficult, and it's done by neurosurgeons. There are many different minimally invasive procedures that is done. One of the most simple ones that nobody considers minimally invasive would be repair of compression fractures, so fractures of the lumbar spine due to osteoporosis. Before, for that repair, it used to do a very large operation. Now we do it through two pinholes and with a cement in about 15 to 20 minutes, as opposed to an operation that usually would take 6 to 7 hours and would involve putting a chest tube in the patient or getting two surgeons involved. That is gone by the wayside. Nowadays, prime example, I just did a case today that involved two bones in the thoracic spine engulfed by tumor. And with a thoracic surgeon, I did the first portion of it anteriorly, replaced the bones, and for the posterior portion, going from the back, putting pedicle screws in, I have four little incisions, and it took me literally 45 minutes to do. Whereas before, it used to be a 4.5-4 hour operation, lots of blood loss. So there are many ways to do minimally invasive, but not everybody is a candidate for minimally invasive. It should not be done on everybody. It has room, and it should be done appropriately.